From the planets to the stars to the systems to the great unknown of the universe. Join us as we explore what lies beyond our solar system. Number 8. The scope of our own solar system. Before we look beyond it, let's take stock of our own solar system and what it is all like. There are 8 definitive planets, and more than that if you count dwarf planets like Pluto. We have one star, the Sun that we orbit around, and within the confines of our system are asteroid belts, various rocks of various sizes, tons of solar rays and radiation, and a whole lot more. Just in our solar system, there is a lot of stuff to explore, which is sometimes hard to find because the length of our solar system is about 287.46 billion kilometers long. And even in the year 2020, we're still finding out things about our solar system that are shocking and surprising. But of course, the main goal of humanity as a whole is to do what many have thought is unthinkable, to go beyond our solar system, and to not just see it, but explore it and live upon it. To truly become a species that is intergalactic instead of just living in one very small part of the universe. Number 7. What lies immediately beyond our solar system? So let's pause it for a moment that you are able to go and get out of the reach of our solar system. Beyond the Kuiper Belt, beyond the heliosphere. What are you going to find when you reach that edge beyond? What will you see? What will you experience? The honest and very simple answer is nothing, because you'll be in what is known as intergalactic space, or the space between galaxies and systems. But to be clear, just because you don't see anything doesn't mean that nothing is there. If you took a cubic meter, there would be less than one atom in it, Michael Shule, an astronomer at the University of Colorado Boulder, told Live Science. But when you add it all up, it's somewhere between 50 and 80% of all the ordinary matter out there. Scientists are honestly deeply interested in this matter, or intergalactic medium, because of how they feel it forms and even replenishes certain systems via the gas that it provides. The reason for this is that the medium is mostly hot, ionized hydrogen. Hydrogen that has lost its electron, with bits of heavier elements such as carbon, oxygen, and silicon thrown in. While these elements typically don't glow bright enough to be seen directly, scientists know they're there because of the signature they leave on light that passes by. IGM is the gas that feeds star formation in galaxies, Shule said. If we didn't have gas falling in, being pulled in by gravity, star formation would slowly grind to a halt as the gas in the galaxy gets used up. But because of its small numbers, when you're floating through space, you're almost literally floating through empty space. Which is why many note that all the planets and stars and celestial objects only fill up about 5% of the known universe. Everything else is minor matter, dark energy, and dark matter. Number 6. Systems beyond our own. Okay, so let's say that you're able to reach another system. What would it be like? Well, that would depend on what you land upon. Because there are at least 100 billion stars in the Milky Way, a spiral galaxy about 100,000 light years across, the stars are arranged in a pinwheel pattern with 4 major arms. And we live in one of them, about 2/3 of the way outward from the center. Most of the stars in our galaxies are thought to host their own families of planets. Thousands of these extrasolar planets, or exoplanets, have been discovered so far, with thousands more candidates detected and awaiting confirmation. Many of these newly discovered planetary systems are quite different from our own. In fact, part of the fun of astronomy in the eyes of many is going and seeing if you can indeed find a new planet or star that hadn't been noticed before, and seeing what details you notice about it. In fact, various agencies from NASA to the ESA and more have made their own satellites and probes and such that they've launched into space or our own atmosphere to try and get better looks at planets and stars and see what we can find. Some of the highlights for sure are many planets that are Earth-like in structure or form or shape. Numerous kinds of stars, from dwarf stars to binary stars to pulsars, supernovas, and more. They found black holes at the center of most galaxies, and that's still only scratching the surface of things. The point here is that regardless of what direction you go in, eventually you're going to find a small system or cluster that has something there, even if you don't realize it at first. That's part of what makes the universe oh so satisfying to think about and explore. Before we dive even deeper into what's beyond our own solar system, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to make our content better for you, the viewer. Also, be sure to subscribe so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Number 5. Beyond our local group. Let's now look beyond just a few systems. Let's talk about galaxies as a whole. The Milky Way is part of the local group, a neighborhood about 10 million light years across, consisting of more than 30 galaxies that are gravitationally bound to each other. Aside from our galaxy, the most massive one in this group is Andromeda, which appears to be on course to collide with the Milky Way in about 4 billion years. That might sound like a freak occurrence, but actually it's not. Since the dawn of time, galaxies have formed, moved, and then collided with one another. When that happens, a whole host of things occur, not the least of which is that the galaxies tend to merge and thus become even larger than they were before things happened. As for Andromeda, these kinds of collisions have happened many times in its life, if certain reports are to be believed. Regardless of that though, every single galaxy has its own stars, its own planets, its own black holes, asteroids, comets, and other things that make it special. Some of them even have unique shapes that defy the spiral pattern that many, including the Milky Way, have. It's one of the dreams of humanity to go across the stars and reach these other galaxies so that we can see what they are like and how they compare to the Milky Way and its contents. Number 4. Exoplanets. We already talked about planets beyond the ones in our solar system, but let's dive a little deeper into this, because a key field of study in astronomy is not just finding planets in the universe, but seeing what they're like and whether they're potentially habitable for humans. Many feel that our best bet right now is in the Alpha Centauri system, which is only about 4.2 light years away. Other planets, though, have been found many thousands of light years away and seem even more plausible to live on once you cross the distance. There are some truly incredible planets out there that would be amazing to see up close. There are planets shaped like eggs instead of spheres. There's one where over one-third of the planet is made of literal diamond. There's even a planet that you almost can't see because its natural color absorbs over 90% of the light shot at it. While we haven't found another Earth just yet, it's not for lack of trying, as new planets are discovered every year, and sometimes every month. Number 3. Pop culture. The mysteries of our universe have long captivated science fiction authors and countless memorable books and films, many of which inspired the real-life scientist and engineering currently exploring the universe. So to say that it is a part of pop culture is honestly a bit of an understatement, because in many ways it is its own genre that we continue to reinvent and explore in various ways to capture the imaginations of millions. Many scientists cite Star Trek, first aired on television in 1966, and reinvented numerous times on both the small and the big screen in the decades since, as an inspiration for various things. Star Trek was, ironically, the true birth of the cell phone via the communicators that the crew of the USS Enterprise had and used to communicate with one another on board the ship and beyond. The various series and movies that followed dealt with all sorts of important issues in the world of space travel, from utilizing various pieces of technology to go farther into space, to having first contact missions, and so much more. Star Trek continues to define the goals of humanity in terms of going beyond our solar system and to boldly go where no man has gone before. Then there was author Arthur C. Clarke's 2001 A Space Odyssey, in which a fictional astronaut is transported across the cosmos through a mysterious portal. This tale is both a memorable movie and a novel. For the next generation, who knows, will be inspired by the 2014 movie Interstellar. A fictional team of astronauts search for a habitable planet around a black hole in a distant galaxy. The 1980 television series Cosmos, featuring Voyager mission scientist Carl Sagan, took viewers on a factual tour of the known universe and sparked the imaginations of many present-day scientists and engineers. The series was reimagined in 2014 with astronomer Neil deGrasse Tyson as the host. In video games, there are plenty of titles that delve into what lies beyond the stars of our own solar system. A popular one is the Mass Effect series, where we discover alien technology that allows us to visit other systems quickly, and humanity quickly becomes a part of the larger order of the universe. The game No Man's Sky dared to try and show players a universe that they could explore on their own and feel the difference that planets could have in the same system and beyond. And let's not forget comics. Both DC Comics and Marvel have created vast universes that feature alien races beyond our own solar system that constantly try and interfere with Earth. It's a constant source of story, and some of the most well-known heroes from both brands are based on planets and systems outside of the solar system, like the Guardians of the Galaxy, the New Gods, Starfire of the Teen Titans, Hawkman and Hawkgirl, the original Captain Marvel, who was a Kree, and more. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. There are many books, cartoons, television shows, comics, and movies that want to try and paint us a picture of what is beyond our solar system, which is why many of them have been wildly successful. People want to think about what is beyond our star and planets, and what could await us out there. And many have used these shows as inspiration to not just go to the stars, but to search them for what might be waiting for us to arrive and see. Number 2. Life? That is the question, isn't it? We know that life lives in our solar system. We're proof of it. But does life live beyond the solar system? That is something many are searching for. In truth, it would be very odd if there wasn't life beyond our solar system, because that would call into question both logical assumptions about the universe as well as philosophical ones of why is it just us? There have been teases and potential sightings of life among the cosmos, including radio signals appearing in a random yet deliberate way. Certain sightings on moons or planets that seem like more than just natural occurrences and more. Until we find definitive proof, the questions will remain, but that's yet another reason to go and explore the stars, to see if we can find more definitive proof that life is out there beyond what we have now. Number 1. The universe beyond. Where is the edge of the universe? That is a question that many, many people have asked over the years. And while it may seem unlikely that of us currently on Earth will ever see it or even come close to it, it's still an important question to ask. Because as many have noted, the universe doesn't really have an edge. In fact, the universe, even to this day, many billions of years after the Big Bang, is still growing. That's right, the universe is infinitely expanding in all directions. In fact, it's expanding at such a rate that it's going beyond what many scientists felt was logical, plausible, and some are even calling for new physics to define exactly how the universe is growing at such a rate. Of course, then the question becomes, what lies in those new areas of space? Well, unfortunately, we don't know, but more than likely, it's nothing but dark energy and dark matter, which, as we noted earlier, makes up 95% of space in the universe. So if a new part of the universe is suddenly made, there is nothing to inhabit it yet. The current size of the known universe is stated to be 93 billion light years across, which is an astounding number. But obviously, there's the unknown universe, and the fact the universe as a whole is still growing. So if you were to ask the question that started off this whole topic of what lies beyond our solar system, the easiest and most complete answer would be a massive universe, and one that is still growing. Thanks for watching, everyone. What did you think of this look at the solar system we live in, the galaxies beyond it, and the universe as a whole? Do you think that humanity will ever truly travel amongst the greater parts of the universe? Or do you think we'll be limited for a great deal of time longer? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.